everyone, welcome back to Star Trek Starfleet Academy, welcome back to 1997, and welcome back to a mission that you don't normally see. If you play through the game normally and don't bother doing any of the Meclanti stuff with Sturek or get high scores in the simulator, well, you will never see this mission. This is 22, A World of Their Own. Now, normally the game would end and you get the cutscene where you're on a Miranda-class cruiser, But mission 22 is very, very tricky because there's some very tricky triggers here in terms of game mechanics. So what we're going to do is go in and see how we get on.
Cadets log. Finally, it's graduation day. Mom and Dad arrived this morning and commencement was a blast.
And it is my honor and privilege to award Cadet David Ross Forrester with the Commandant's Award of Meritorious Service and the Starfleet Call of Duty Award. Congratulations, Lieutenant Commander Forrester.
Thank you, sir.
Congratulations, Lieutenant Commander.
Thank you, sir.
You've done brilliantly, Lieutenant. I must say I'm impressed. I've never seen a whole team of cadets turn down their postings to continue serving with their training captain.
Congratulations, David. You've drawn a full bridge crew for your mission.
My mission, sir?
We're giving you a chance to test your Meclanti theory in the field.
You'll patrol the neutral zone for 2 weeks looking for the Meclanti. And you have a field promotion to captain.
Thank you, sir.
Captain Kirk thought that your Meclanti simulation deserved more than just a commencement award.
She's been in dry dock for 6 weeks, and she needs someone to put her through her paces.
The Enterprise? I don't know what to say, sir.
And just have her back by midnight and don't scratch the paint.
Captain, the Enterprise is hailing us. We have permission to come aboard.
This is Turk right over here. Ensigns Karn and Acton.
What the hell?
Ensign McGee? Communications?
Aye, sir.
Mr. Brady? Engineering's right over there.
Thank you, sir. I can't believe this. I've been studying this all my life.
We've heard that before. Mr. Forrester, the command chair.
Aye, sir.
Go on, Captain. Take her out.
Helmsman, impulse power. Captain's log, stardate 0000.2. My first patrol with my new ship and my old crew has gone very well. We're serving as an advanced scout ship for the USS Turong. We've been patrolling near the neutral zone for over a month now, searching the most recently destroyed Federation colony. Still no sign of the Meclanti. Despite the gravity of our mission, I can't help feeling slightly excited.
Captain, the USS Truong is late.
What was the Truong's most recent destination?
The Truong was headed for the Federation colony on Javik 6.
Korn, set a course for Javik 6.
Course laid in, Captain.
We're just going to go to damage control. I'm going to do exactly what we've done before. Shields up, warp down, tractor beam down, and then last three up. And this mission is a pain in the butt. I've been trying to do it for 2 days, just to give you an idea of how much of a pain in the butt it is. Because there is a trigger later on in the mission that sometimes just fails to work or is very tricky to get to work. Right, so we're going to get a warp.
Arrived in the Javik system. No sign of the Truong. Captain! I'm tracking some debris in orbit around the Javik 6.
Let's scan Javik 6.
David, the colony has been destroyed. There are no life signs on Javik 6.
All those people.
There are deep craters punched into the planetary crust. It's consistent with the Meclanti attack.
So the Meclanti can't be very far from here.
Let's scan the debris.
The debris is from a Federation ship, the USS Truong.
It's been ripped to shreds.
That means we're alone with the Meclanti. Why didn't we receive a distress call?
It is probable that the force of the Meclanti attack destroyed the Truong before they could react.
Can you follow the Meclanti energy signature?
Yes. The Meclanti energy trail is on a heading of 116 Mark 8, toward the neutral zone.
Course laid in, Captain.
Scanners detecting an unknown ship. It is in Federation space heading toward the Klingon neutral zone at warp factor 9. The energy pattern is consistent with the Meclanti.
At that speed, we can only hope to catch it if it stops.
The Meclanti ship has just crossed into the neutral zone.
Damn it, we're so close!
Damn it! Break off the chase. We'll monitor it from the border. We can't enter the neutral zone.
I'm picking up a distress call, Captain. It's from the Klingons.
On screen.
This is Klingon Research Station, board chart 7, on Kurat 1. We are under attack by an alien vessel. This is Commander 4, calling any ship. We are a medical facility, researching pediatric wasting disease and Jorkot. We're isolated from all Klingon planets and have 10,000 innocent young here.
Magia, hail the Klingon. Magia, contact that station. We hear you, Commander Vor.
Federation?
I'm Captain Forrester of the USS Enterprise.
You must assist us!
We'd like to, but we can't enter the neutral zone.
Our planetary defenses were not made to fight this beast. I beg you, enter our space and aid us.
I'm on my way, Commander Vor.
I will bear full responsibility for your rescue mission. Vor out!
Captain, this could be a trap.
That is possible. A facility such as Vor described could be a Klingon stratagem to prey on Federation compassion.
No. No, I think Commander Vor sounds genuinely desperate.
I agree with Magia. Like Sun Tzu's 33rd strategy says, use your enemy's agents against him.
Magia! Send Starfleet a message with a data recording of Vor's invitation. Korn, set coordinates for Vor's location.
Data recording sent, Captain.
Course laid in, Captain.
Right, we're going to cross into the neutral zone. We're going to go to Red Alert, and we are going to warp.
There's the Meclanti. Big as life.
The Meclanti continues to fire on Kurat 1. They're not doing anything else we can mimic.
Okay, we need to select Kurat 1, select it, face it, and fire.
The Meclanti continues to fire on Kurat 1. They're not doing anything else we can mimic. Captain, the Meclanti ship has stopped bombarding the planet. It's turning to face us.
It appears we have gained its attention.
I suggest that we continue to mimic the Meclanti's actions. Fascinating. The Meclanti is turning its secondary weapons towards us.
There is clearly a new pattern in the Meclanti's broadcasts.
I suspect that the message concerns us and our actions. McGee and I will attempt to connect their words to our actions.
So this is the bit that gets me every single time. We need to select them. We're just out of range of photons. We need to fire a photon. If we get this wrong, Klingons turn up.
Captain, the Meclanti has ceased firing.
The Meclanti broadcast has changed again.
I hypothesize that the Meclanti are talking to themselves about our behavior. McGee and I will now attempt to fit the new message to our actions.
The more our ship mimics the Meclanti's actions, the more we reach into their semantic world. The deeper we enter their world, the better our chance of actually communicating.
Captain, the Meclanti ship is now moving toward the planet.
Which means we need to move towards the planet.
Captain, the Meclanti ship is moving away from the planet.
Which means we need to move away from the planet. And hopefully not ram into them.
Captain, McGee and I have made several connections between the Meclanti actions and the Meclanti words.
We know the basic Meclanti terms for stop, start, fly, ship, shields, energy, planet, star, shoot, damage, wound, and debris. We can also communicate numbers and relative distance.
Now that we have entered their semantic world, we should be able to engage in rudimentary communication.
Hail them, McGee.
You, Meclanti.
Suspend communication for a minute, McGee. That's a bit too rudimentary. What's he saying, Stark?
Do they think we're another Meclanti?
Possibly. But it's more likely that we simply cannot isolate their word for themselves from their word for us.
True. After all, both our ships are performing the same actions.
Start communications again, McGee. Meclanti, we are the Starship Enterprise.
One Meclanti, one Enterprise, one planet.
Yes, one Meclanti, one Enterprise, one planet.
Captain, this is helping. The more we communicate, the easier it gets to decipher their transmissions.
Meclanti flies. Enterprise flies. Meclanti shoots. Enterprise shoots.
Meclanti shoots. Enterprise shoots. Meclanti flies. Enterprise flies.
Enterprise. Meclanti. Meclanti. Enterprise.
Enterprise, Meclanti. Meclanti, Enterprise.
We're missing some important words here.
The transmission streams show that the Meclanti are comparing themselves to us. We are attempting to isolate the phrases.
Got it. We've got their logical operators.
We've interpreted the elegant logical structure that informs the Meclanti's cybernetic intelligence.
He means that we can now understand words like and, or, and not.
The Meclanti think that everything else in the universe is random, because nothing else behaves according to their precise understanding of logic. And they have no compunction about destroying anything they deem random.
I've interpreted the Meclanti message, Captain. I'm putting it on screen.
Enterprise is Meclanti, but Meclanti is not Enterprise.
Yes! Enterprise is Meclanti, but Meclanti is not Enterprise.
Meclanti not random. An Enterprise not random.
Right! Meclanti not random and Enterprise not random.
Star is random.
Interesting. Yes, Meclanti. Stars are random.
Planet is random.
The planet Karat 1 is not random.
Planet shoots random. Planet flies random.
Meclanti not damage random planet.
Meclanti damage planet Kurat 1. Planet Kurat 1 is random. Meclanti not wound Enterprise. Enterprise is not random.
Fascinating. The Meclanti see a distinction between objects which are damaged and beings which are wounded.
Meclanti stop wounding planet Kurat 1.
Planet Kurat 1 is energy.
You want energy?
Meclanti wants energy, planet energy, Enterprise energy.
Fascinating. The Meclanti learned to express the concept of want after you use the word. Now that we have entered their semantic world, they have gained the ability to enter ours.
Robin, can we give the Meclanti some energy?
The Meclanti ship has energy conduits all over its exterior and energy processing units inside it. I can send a controlled energy burst into one and see if they can process it.
Do it. Meclanti, Enterprise energy is Meclanti energy.
Feeding controlled energy bursts into the Meclanti energy conduit.
Energy, Enterprise energy is Meclanti energy.
The Meclanti ship has accepted the energy transfer. The Meclanti ship is successfully processing the energy burst.
Sensors show that the Meclanti is creating new molecular pathways in the middle of their ship. They're increasing their neural capacity.
So they're actually getting smarter?
More accurately, they are building into themselves the capacity to interpret our language.
Meclanti less wounded. Meclanti wants planet to stop wound forever.
The Meclanti need a planet with the proper mineral content to survive.
Judging from the energy transference, the Meclanti need a planet rich in heavy metals and dilithium crystals.
Good. Meclanti, we can give you a home planet.
Enterprise is good.
Captain, Klingon ships decloaking. Two birds of prey and one D7.
Hail them, Magia.
Hailing channel open!
You have violated Klingon space! Prepare to be destroyed!
Wait! We're here on the authority of Commander Vore.
My communications officer has informed me your permission is valid. You may stay if you wish, and witness us destroy this monster.
But we have the means to get this alien out of Klingon space.
That monster murders everything in its path. It must die.
We can communicate with the aliens. We can stop their rampage without harming the Klingon colony.
This is a Federation trick. That ship is a war machine.
Magia, transmit all data on the Meclanti to the Klingons.
Transmitting. All data sent.
Interesting. This thing is a simpleton. We understand why you would wish to take it out of Klingon space.
Captain, both birds of prey are warping out of the system. The D7 is flying towards the sun.
Commander Vore is hailing us again.
On screen.
Those vermin, those honorless cowards, they would slaughter my innocent children to satisfy their lust for vengeance.
Vore, how does the D7 intend to destroy the Meclanti?
The D7's left warp wing is outfitted with a fusion disruptor, a device that creates solar flares. If the D7 flies into the sun, it will incinerate all life in the solar system. You have little chance of outrunning it.
We've got to stop that D7 without involving the Meclanti.
Okay, we got to take out the D7.
Captain's log, mission summary. We succeeded in destroying the D7 without involving the Meclanti. We saved the Meclanti and kept them out of the tensions between the Klingons and the Federation. We also saved Commander Vore's hospital. Not bad for a day's work.
As you were.
I knew you could do it. You not only met our expectations, but you far exceeded them. Congratulations.
Your analysis of the Meclanti anti-electron matrix has moved our cybernetics program ahead by decades.
Oh, by the way, Chancellor Gorkin of the Klingon High Council called. He says your courage has shown just how archaic the neutral zone has become. I'm not sure I agree with him, but that's quite an admission from a Klingon. Gentlemen, here's to the future of Starfleet and the next generation of captains. Who will lead them there?
Here.
Space. The final frontier. These are the continuing voyages to seek out new life and new civilizations, and to boldly go where no one has gone before.
Excellent. That's actually the first time I've been able to complete that mission. The secret to it is to highlight the planet by fire a couple of phaser shots, just two phaser shots, highlight the Meclanti and make sure the rectangle around them is green. If it's any other color than green, or if you fire a photon torpedo anywhere other than directly at the Meclanti, a bunch of Klingons turn up and you get the game over cutscene, essentially, as the sun blows up. You have to almost try and pop the Meclanti with a photon, but only after Sturek says, We gotta do that. If you fire a photon torpedo at any other time in that system, it's game over. So the trigger for that is very, very fine. And then you have the dialogue tree on top, which is, it's a one to navigate. Anyway, that's the finale. I'm glad if you've joined me through all of this. Thank you, very much. Thank you for watching. If you'd like to leave a like, that would be appreciated. If you haven't done so already, I would recommend subscribing because it's free and it'll make me feel happy. It should make you feel happy. And I'll tell you what, I'll catch you next time.